Dear voters of Punggol East, Sengkang West, friends and fellow Singaporeans, a very good evening. We have entered a critical phase in this election. PAP has shown its hands. They have embarked on a personal attack against me to try to discredit me. The Prime Minister has personally gone down to Aljunied GRC to campaign for the PAP team. Even though the PAP Aljunied team is led by two ministers and the future Speaker of Parliament, and they need the Prime Minister to help to campaign. I believe the PAP may also make use of the media to mock me. So, please be careful of what you read in a newspaper and what you see on TV. Please come and attend our rallies in the next 2 days and help us to spread the message and keep checking our website at wp.sg, www.wp.sg. That's a website. First, I want to respond to Minister Mrs. Lin Wee Hua's accusation about Hougang Town Council's account. She said, I quote, "It is messy, or are they holding back till after elections so that whoever wins Hougang will then inherit the account," unquote. That's what she said. Do you believe that Lau Thia Khiang is dishonest? Do you believe that if the account of Hougang Town Council is messy, I can win Hougang for 20 years? The account of Hougang Town Council, like any town council from the PAP, has to be audited by a public accountant approved by the Ministry of National Development. In short form is MND, Ministry for National Development. After the audit is completed, it has to be submitted to the MND, Ministry for National Development, and the Auditor General for approval. Then, like all statutory boards, it has to be presented to the Parliament and circulated to every member of Parliament. If the account is messy, as what she claimed, why would MMD and the Auditor General approve it? They are sleeping? Moreover, Minister Lim, as a member of Parliament, would have received a copy of Hougang Town Council's report. But she has not made any observations earlier until now. What is she trying to do with her irresponsible comments? May I take this chance to remind her that during the Lehman Brothers crisis, I believe you remember, due to our prudent handling of funds, Hougang Town Council is one of those who make no losses. Next, she brings in the issue of the privatization of HUDC estates in Hougang Avenue 7 to try to confuse the people. When I took over the town council in 1991, when I was elected, the HUDC estate is part of the Hougang estate managed by the town council. The fund received an expenditure of the HUDC estate together with HDB flats are all taken in as one single account under the account of Hougang Town Council. Now that these blocks are to be privatized and they will manage themselves like condominiums, the accounts and expenses attributed to them needs to be segregated. The balance will then be transferred to the account by a date given by the HDB. Since this is the first time Hougang Town Council has needed to do this, we want to be extra sure that the account separation is done properly. We wanted to avoid future disputes on final amount transfer to the HUDC when it is privatized. On 23rd of August 2010, we wrote to HDB asking for advice and guidance on method, format, and principle to separate the account after we received the privatization note from them. On 24th of November 2010, the HDB replied that Hougang Town Council will have to decide on the basis of splitting the account. Hougang Town Council then started preparation for the process by discussing with the auditor the job scope and modification of the computer system to capture the expenditures and receivables separately. On 17th of March 2011, the auditor was appointed, and on 11th of April, the certified apportioned sinking fund based on audited account as at 31st of March 2010 was completed. Right now, Hougang Town Council is in the process of capturing expenditure apportioned to the HUDC estate between 31st of March 2010 and 31st of March 2011. Once the audited account for the HUDC estate is completed and presented to Parliament, Hougang Town Council will give a copy to the Proton Committee. The Proton Committee is a committee which formed in the process of privatization, a temporary committee, and will become the management committee of the estate. The HDB privatization briefing note to Hougang Town Council stated that the role of the town council is to hand over the operating and sinking fund to the management committee upon legal privatization. On 6th of April, HDB told Hougang Town Council that they have obtained the required consent for privatization. That means the HUDC estate, they're going for a vote and they have obtained the consent. Or a gauge of the consent. But the duration to legally privatize the estate is 2.5 years. I have called for a report on this issue, and Hougang Town Council has given me the correspondence between the Town Council, HDB, and the Proton Committee Chairman. It seems like everyone was in the loop except Mrs. Lim Wee Hua. I see this as an accusation of my character as chairman of the town council. What more done by someone who is totally out of the whole story? I leave it to you to guess her intention. You have done something fishy to the account. I will have been sued now. During this election, I would like to take time to tell you more about the Workers' Party message and policies, and not having to answer to such nonsense accusations. I would like to tell the PAP, if they suspect that I've done anything wrong with the account, do report me to the CPIB. Do not hoodwink the voters at this critical time when polling day is near. This is PAP's typical, usual tactic. You all know. Do you still remember the case of CCTV footage from the election department during the last election?
Yeah.
Who?
Yeah.
The election is a serious matter. I will be focused in the next 2 days to urge the voters to vote for the Workers' Party and move towards a first world parliament.
Yeah.
Thank you.